Joy is the focus of so much attention, in fact, that the show's producers have special phone numbers which viewers can call to name the baby. And what do the proud parents-to-be think of all this fuss? Well, James Brady is here to talk with both of the parents tonight, Lisa Brown and Michael Tylo from Guiding Light.
The biggest thing since Charles and Di had a baby.
I guess so.
But your baby on television was actually born this afternoon.
Yes, it was. Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You look terrific. You know,
Thanks.
You came out of it like that.
Very well.
It was very easy, yes.
This is I suppose it's a gimmick, but it seems a very appealing one, that they've been playing with this idea that in real life, you've been pregnant, you've had your baby. How long ago?
3 months ago, February 18th.
Okay, so your character in Guiding Light has been pregnant at the same time.
Yes.
You're the proud and nervous father, one assumes at this point. And everyone is wondering, just is the baby going to be named after you, Quentin, or after somebody else? And you, Nola, are very up in the air about the whole thing.
Yes, yes. That there are
three possibilities.
Yeah.
And they're all boys' names. How did you know in Guiding Light that you were definitely going to have a boy?
The head writer told us.
Yeah. No, they told, I guess they had planned, you know, months ago in the storyline, and I just happened to have a boy, so it worked out really well.
But
and
intuitively, you knew that you were going to have a boy.
Oh, yes, yes, I knew. Yes.
Okay. The head writer and I have gotten together before this interview. We have a piece of tape, and your character, Nola Chamberlain, you're so obsessed by this idea of what the child's name should be that you, in your fantasy, you go to the Yellow Brick Road.
Yes.
You head for the Wizard of Oz and you run into the Scarecrow.
Yes. Quentin, what do I do?
If you want a name that sounds intelligent and deep, you should choose Quentin.
Who said that? Who said that, you? Well, I don't know if I like Quentin. I think it sounds like a video game.
It does? Well, maybe you're right. What do I know? I'm just a scarecrow. I haven't got a brain.
You don't?
Don't what?
Have a brain?
I don't.
You don't what? Oh, never mind. Look, why don't you get down from there? You don't look very comfortable. And come with me. I'm going to Emerald City to see the wizard. He can do anything. Oh, my
Quentin, a video game?
Yes.
Do you resent that at all in your role?
No, I don't resent it. I've always liked the name Quentin. When I got onto the soap opera and they said your name is going to be Quint McCord, I thought, well, yeah, that sounds interesting.
And you think that Quentin is going to win, too, don't you?
I do think Quentin is going
yes.
to win.
Well, we don't know that yet, but did you have the same problem in naming your own child? Your husband, Tom, is actually on the show.
Yes, he plays Floyd.
Yeah. Did you two have trouble naming your own son?
Yeah, we were thinking of, relatives, and we finally settled on...
Relatives? That's a funny name for a kid.
Relatives. Relatives Nielsen. Well, that's rather Danish, you know. Then we settled on, after our fathers, James Anthony, which is very much like Anthony James, but his real name is James Anthony.
And he's going to play the baby on the show?
Yes. He's already worked. He had his first day last Friday.
Has he gotten the check yet?
No.
Okay.
His check.
Well,
his check.
Out there across America, people will have the opportunity on Wednesday and Thursday of this week of actually calling a certain 900 number, and you'll be able to vote for the name that you think the baby should be named, and that name will be selected on Friday from your votes, and I'm going to read the three names. If you believe it should be Quentin Jr., you ring 900-210-1111. If you think it should be Anthony James, 900-210-2222. If you think it should be Thomas Henry, 900-210-3333. How are you two betting?
Well, I'm betting Quentin Jr.
Okay.
I'm betting Anthony James.
We'll know on Friday. Jim?
Just ahead.